Hello, beautiful, and thank you for joining me today. What I'm going to be doing in this little short little training is really just go over sort of my steps that I go through with my clients when they have fallen off track and they need help getting started again. And just yesterday I was talking with one of my clients who had been doing really, really awesome inside my program. She was about 14 or 15 weeks into the program, probably about 14 weeks into the program, like felt like on fire. And then she had her summer vacation and suddenly found herself, found all of her prior habits sort of coming back. And so when she finished her vacation, she's like, all right, I've got to get back on track. But was noticing that it was just really hard. Like her mindset wasn't in the right place. And her, she was just struggling to get back into the into her healthy habits that I've been teaching her. So so she scheduled a one-on-one coaching call with me, and we kind of went through these different steps that that I think can be really helpful in helping anyone get back on track. And so if that is you, if you have gotten off track either because you went on a vacation somewhere, or because, just summer in general, and you're now like, okay, well, now it's August and I've got to start thinking about getting back on track, then this is definitely for you. And I want to start by saying that it is perfectly normal. The fact that you got off track is perfectly normal. It happens to everyone. It happens to coaches as well. It happens to pretty much every single woman inside my program. So let's go into the different steps that you can take to sort of get your mindset back on track and get your habits back on track. All right, so let's talk about step one. So step one, in my personal opinion, is meal planning and meal prep. Anytime that I feel like I've gotten off track, at Christmas or whenever after a vacation, this is a habit that I get right back into. It's a habit that is crucial inside my program. And so I get my clients to plan out their entire week, go to the grocery store, get all of their groceries done, and set aside a little bit of time on the weekend. The reason that this can be really helpful is that, again, like if you've gotten off track, making sure, I mean, the planning is key, but more importantly are the groceries and the prep, because you want to make sure that you're not tempted, that there's less temptation. That's what it's all about, right? So you want to make sure that you have those foods in your house and you've got a plan and, put it up on your fridge. That will help you to create those intentions and to remind yourself of what you're doing. And it just sets you up. You're set up for success that week. If you continue winging it, which a lot of us do during the holidays, if you continue winging it, what's going to happen is that then every single time you have to make a decision. What am I going to do? I'm going to make a healthy choice, or am I going to make the unhealthy choice? We want to try to eliminate those decisions as much as possible. So that is step number one. You want to plan out your meals for the week. You want to get to the grocery store, get all that food in, and do a little bit of prep work so that it's just easier to make the right decision. Okay. Step number two is control your environment. This is another one that's really huge. And what I often say to my clients is that your environment can either work for you or against you. And you want to set it up so that it's working for you. And so that means going back to step number one, filling your house with the foods that are going to help you reach your goals, as well as getting rid of the foods that are going to impede your goals, right? And so basically it's about giving yourself a little bit of a kitchen makeover just creating an environment that is supportive of your goals. And what we, what I teach as a coach is that essentially when you can control your environment, it's like you're putting on your seatbelt. This is your safety net. Right? Again, it's going to help you so that there is less decision to make. You don't have to decide between a healthy choice and an unhealthy choice. You've set up your environment to lead you to those healthy choices. Okay. The third step is you want to eliminate triggers that lead you to those unhealthy choices. Okay. And so I'll give you an example. So my client, one of the things that she was noticing was that, you know, she was still kind of like in that vacation mode. So they were eating a little bit later, and then they'd kind of go and watch Netflix and they'd stay up late. And then as soon as they put the Netflix on, for her, that triggered this desire to go and get more food in the fridge because it was her trigger, right? And oftentimes the habits get tied together. So for her, Netflix and late night snacking went together. And so, you know, in our discussions, I was like, okay, well, if Netflix is the trigger, get rid of the trigger, at least for the next couple of weeks until you feel like the ball is rolling again. Find something else to do in the evening. So what I would recommend for you to do is kind of like take a look at the triggers. What triggers the bad behavior, and can you eliminate that at least for a couple of weeks just to get the ball rolling? Because here's the thing when it comes to getting back on track. I want you to visualize like a big rock, right? Like a massive rock that's very heavy. When it is not moving, the first initial push is really, really, really hard. But once the ball is moving, it is so much easier to maintain that momentum. And so that's what you've got to do. You've got to get that ball rolling. And so we want to eliminate any obstacles that are going to make it hard to get that initial push. Okay. So eliminating those triggers, at least for a short period of time. The number four step is bringing awareness. And so this is important because oftentimes what can happen is we have these habit loops, right? So we have these sort of automatic behaviors that we just do without even noticing that we're doing them, right? And so you go through the motions and you catch yourself when it's too late. And they're called habit loops. And so we have to create like a pattern interrupt, right? So again, for my client, what she had noticed is that 14 weeks into the program, all of her, you know, signs and symptoms of perimenopause had pretty much disappeared. And then on vacation, again, brought back in lots of like refined processed foods, alcohol, you know, more carbs, more sugar, all of that stuff. And all of these symptoms came back. And so one of the things that I wanted to do to help her was to help her sort of, again, like interrupt these habit loops so that she could, again, set and, you know, remind herself of why she's doing this. So a simple little trick that sounds silly, but is just to put a post-it note on the foods that you know are not going to help if they're still in the house, right? Because I understand for some of you, you're like, okay, I have kids. If I try and get rid of all the chips, you know, it's going to be a problem. But what you can do is you can put a little post-it note on the foods that you know are not going to help you. And so what I told her was, you know, like, for example, you know, chocolate, right? And so I was like, put a little post-it note on the chocolate or in the area where the chocolate is and just write chocolate or hot flashes. Right? What do you want? Again, it's just enough to interrupt that habit loop so that you can make a decision. Maybe you'll still make the unhealthy decision, but at least you are doing it with awareness. Okay, and that is super, super key. And then the fifth one is to reset your intentions, right? Because ultimately, when it comes to changing our habits, we have to have the intrinsic desire, the motivation to actually do it. And, you know, with all of my clients, you know, I talk about their goals when they first start the program, but it can be really easy to forget those goals and to forget the original intention of why you're doing something. So what I highly recommend, if that is you, is take some time to write down what your goals are. What are you hoping to achieve? Why is this important to you? Because all of that is going to get you into the right mindset. And that is probably the most important thing of all, is that you need to get into the right mindset in order to make these changes happen. So I hope that helps. So again, the five steps: we want to meal plan and prep to set ourselves up for making better choices. We want to control our environment. We want to put that seatbelt on and make sure that our environment is supportive of our goals. We want to eliminate the triggers that lead us to our bad behaviors. We want to bring awareness to our behaviors, to the habit loops that are potentially automatic. And we want to reset our intentions to reignite the motivation to create those changes. I really hope this was helpful. And, let me know if it was. I would love to hear from you. If there's any other things that you're struggling with that you'd like to see a little mini training on, please let me know. And have a fantastic day.